Cellular respiration explained with animation and puppets. Cellular respiration requires sugar from your food and oxygen from the air. Cellular respiration happens within the mitochondria, producing carbon dioxide and energy in the form of ATP. H2O, or water, is also produced. So how does it all work? To answer this, we'll need a volunteer. Excuse us, sir. Over here. Sir, yes, you there. Hi. Do you think you could help us out today? Thank you. This represents a mitochondria inside this volunteer's body. We'll need him to eat first. Sir, could you eat that? As he eats that, the sugars in the food will enter his blood. Then the sugars will make their way into a cell and finally reach a mitochondria. However, we still need one more thing. We need oxygen. Sir, could you breathe in for us? One more time, sir. The oxygen will go from his lungs to his blood and finally make their way to a cell's mitochondria. Now that we have oxygen and sugar, those two things will enter the mitochondria, and through cellular respiration, they will become energy, carbon dioxide, and H2O. Energy in the form of ATP will be used to think, grow, and/or repair. Energy is also used to move, or whatever this is. We still have some waste products, carbon dioxide and H2O. We're going to have our volunteer exhale. Breathe out. One more time. When he does this, it removes the carbon dioxide from the body. Water molecules will remain in the body until they're lost through moisture in the breath, or sweating, or some other bodily processes. Thank you, sir, for all your help. Yes, goodbye. Goodbye, you can go now. It's over. Okay. Thank you for watching. I hope you learned something.